Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamsforyou.com. Today the topic of our discussion is understanding pedigree analysis. We'll be discussing what is pedigree chart, what are the different inheritance pattern, and how can we easily solve pedigree analysis problems. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and support this channel. Please watch till the end for complete understanding. Let's begin. Starting with why we need a pedigree chart. A pedigree chart is a diagrammatic representation that shows the presence or absence of a trait, a character, or a disorder in a family over several generations. Genetic counselors use this to track genetic diseases. Let's begin with some important symbols to understand pedigree chart. The circle represents female, square represents male. If it is filled, that indicates affected individuals. A horizontal line between male and female indicates parents unrelated. Two lines, horizontal lines, indicates related parents or consanguineous parents. And these represent the offsprings 1, 2, 3, 4, starting from eldest to the youngest. So these are the major symbols used in pedigree chart. Let's begin with some background concepts for better understanding and also for solving pedigree analysis problems in an easier way. Affected individuals is denoted in filled, square, or circle. Suppose the allele is D. Then there are two probabilities. It can be a homozygote like this, capital D, or small d may be affected. The second possibility is heterozygote, D, and there are two possibilities. Sometimes may be affected, sometimes it become a carrier, depending on the nature of the allele. If it is a dominant allele, then this heterozygote condition, that person will be affected. If it is a recessive allele, that person will become a carrier. This is the first concept. Second concept, this is very important in solving problems related to sex-linked inheritance. Point number one is, in the case of male, the X chromosome is received from the mother and Y chromosome is received from the father. Whereas in the case of females, one of the X chromosome is received from the father and one of the X chromosome is received from the mother. And this understanding is very important for solving problems related to sex-linked inheritance. Now starting with the simplest inheritance pattern. And these are wonderful pictures for easy understanding. And this is from NIH, and I have given the link and I will be dropping the link in the description also for your reference. So in the case of Y-linked inheritance, Y chromosome, as it is present only in males, it is passed from father to son. Affected men pass the trait to all sons. You can see this son is affected and this son is also affected, as this Y chromosome is transferred from father to the son, all sons. Daughters are not affected as daughters doesn't have Y chromosome. The trait doesn't skip generations. Examples include hairy ears, retinitis pigmentosa, etc. Now let us see a pedigree chart for better understanding. So this is a typical pedigree chart of Y-linked inheritance. As you can see, this field indicates that this father is affected. And you can see in the next generation also, all the males are affected. This male 4 is affected and this male 8 is affected. From that also, in the next generation also, this 10 and 11 is affected. So the typical characteristics of Y-linked inheritance are: point number one, all males are affected. Point number two, only males are affected. As you can see, daughters are not affected at all. Point number three, this type of inheritance doesn't skip generations. As you can see, this in this generation, first generation, second generation also, there is individuals with the disorder, and in the third generation also there is individuals with that disorder. Hope this is fine. Now moving into the second pattern, that is X-linked dominant traits. X-linked dominant traits are more in females than males. As you know, there are two X chromosomes in females. Let's take the case one. If a father is affected, then father will pass that affected X chromosomes to all daughters. So as it is a dominant trait, all daughters will get affected also. There is no male-to-male transmission, as this father gives only the Y chromosome to the sons. So in the case of X-linked dominant trait, if the father is affected, all daughters become affected, as the X chromosome, which is dominant, the disorder is dominant, is received from the father. Case number two, if mother is affected. If mother is affected, both daughters and sons are affected, often 50% chance. As you can see, this is a dominant allele. So one of the X chromosome, the chance of getting is 50% if there are four children. This trait also, as it is dominant, doesn't skip generations. Examples include fragile X syndrome. So in this son, as you can see, this affected X chromosome is transferred from the mother and this Y chromosome from the father. So here there is one chromosome which is not affected, and that is transferred to this unaffected son. Therefore, that particular son is not affected. Now let us see the pedigree chart. As you can see, in X-linked dominant trait, affected mother, of the four offsprings, 50% are affected. It can, both males and females are affected if the mother is affected. In the case of males, as you can see, this is the affected father. All daughters are affected, as you can see, 8 and 10. Both daughters are affected, indicating that this is an X-linked dominant trait. So point number one, if the father is affected, all daughters will also get affected. If the mother is affected, 50% of the progenies will be affected. Both males and females has the same chance of getting the disorder. Moving into the third pattern, that is X-linked recessive disorder. It is more in males than females. If the father is affected, there will be carrier daughters. As you can see, one of the X chromosome will be transferred to this daughter, and other X chromosome, one of the X chromosome is transferred to this daughter. So daughters become carriers. There is no male-to-male transmission, as father only passes Y chromosome to the sons. If mother is a carrier, the second option is, if mother is a carrier, then 1/4 of the children gets affected, and only males are affected, whereas the daughter becomes the carrier, as this is a recessive trait. In the case of females, there are two X chromosomes, so recessive trait will not express in heterozygous condition in females, so females become carriers. Whereas in the case of son or males, there is only single X chromosome. If that recessive X chromosome is received by that particular person or particular child, that child gets affected. Then the third possibility, if mother is affected, as a recessive disorder, it should be small d or small x, then all sons becomes affected. Son will receive the X chromosome from the mother, so all sons get affected. Here, as it is a recessive trait, there are carriers in between, therefore the trait skips one or more generations. Examples include hemophilia, Fabry disease, etc. Let's look into a pedigree chart of X-linked recessive trait. As you can see, this is the affected mother. Then, as you can see, four offsprings, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and all males are affected. All sons are affected. Then here you can see carrier mother. Then out of the four offsprings, one male is affected. So one out of four gets the disorder. Here also you can see in this pattern, males are more affected, as males are having a single X chromosome. Therefore, recessive trait will express easily as there is only one X chromosome. If both the parents has the disorder, then all the children will get the disorder. Now moving into fourth, that is autosomal dominant disorder. So previously 1, 2, 3 we have discussed disorders that is happening in sex chromosomes, that is X and Y chromosomes. So such disorders are called as sex-linked inheritance or sex-linked disorders, where mutation occurs in sex chromosomes. Now autosomal dominant disorders. Autosomal disorders are disorders that is happening in all chromosomes other than sex chromosomes. In the case of autosomal dominant disorder, affected children are born to affected parents. So this particular father is, this father is affected. So the chance is both the males and females are affected in equal frequency, and 50% children affected from affected parents. Of the four offsprings, two will be getting the disease. Here also, as it is a dominant disorder, this trait doesn't skip generations. Examples include Huntington disease, Marfan syndrome, polydactyly, neurofibromatosis type 1, achondroplasia. So as you can see, if the parents are heterozygous, then as this is a dominant trait, out of 4, 3 will be affected and 1 will remain unaffected. Let's take a pedigree chart for better understanding. So this is a typical of autosomal dominant trait. As you can see, affected parents, then the chance is 3 out of 4 will be affected. Here also, out of 3, 2 are affected. If both parents are affected, as it is a dominant trait, if there are 4 offsprings, 75% will be affected. And if one parent is affected, then 50% of the offsprings will get the disorder. As you can see, out of 2 offsprings, 1 is affected and 1 is unaffected. And this will not skip generation. These 10, 11 and 12 are not affected, as the parents are not affected. Let me repeat once more. In the case of autosomal dominant trait, if both parents are affected, 3 out of 4 of the offsprings will get the disorder. If one of the parent is affected, then 50% of the offspring will get the disorder. Only affected parents give rise to affected offsprings. Moving into the next one and the final one, that is autosomal recessive disorder. Here also, affected children are born to affected or carrier parent. Both males and females are having equal chance of getting this disorder. If both parents are carriers, this, take this case, autosomal recessive. If both parents are carriers, then 1 out of 4 will get the disorder. 1 out of 4 will get the disorder, as this is a recessive trait. Both the recessive alleles should come together. Maybe take the case as small d, small d. The trait often skips generation as it is a recessive trait. There are carriers in between. These autosomal recessive disorders are mostly seen in progeny of related individuals or consanguineous mating. Examples include cystic fibrosis, sickle cell disease, etc. Here also, as you can see, this is heterozygous carrier. The father is also heterozygous carrier. Then one will be affected and two will be carriers and one will be unaffected. In total, 25% of the offspring gets the disorder. Now let's take a pedigree chart. This is an autosomal recessive pedigree chart. As you can see, this father is affected. As it is a recessive trait, the individuals in this generation, there is no disorder indicating a recessive trait. One parent is affected. Then 1/4 out of 1, 2, 3, 9, 10 and 12, 3 offspring, 1 is affected. If both are affected, as this is a recessive trait, if both parents are affected, all the offsprings will also get the disorder. Here you can see this type of inheritance pattern often skips generation. In first generation, there is an affected individual, and here there is the offsprings are fine. Then in the next generation, there may be carriers. In the next generation, then again comes offsprings with the disease. That indicates that this is an autosomal recessive trait. Hope you are fine with this concept. Just want to add one more point. Autosomal recessive traits usually appear equally in males and females, that we have discussed. There may be unaffected individuals, as this one or two may be a carrier. That can lead, maybe heterozygous. This is heterozygous carrier that lead to the disease in this generation. Then the chance of getting this autosomal recessive trait is often with progenies of related individuals. These two horizontal lines indicates related marriage or consanguineous marriage. Then the chance of autosomal recessive traits are high. As you can see, then the reappearance of affected individuals. So it often skips generation. In the second generation, there are no affected individual. Then there may be carrier. Often there will be carrier. This 3 and 4 will definitely be a carrier, and that lead to the reappearance of affected individuals. In the next generation, this 2 is affected. Hope you are fine with these concepts. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com. If you like this video, please subscribe, share and support this channel.